Kathleen ISD would hold meetings with doors locked. The true facts that were not printed in the article are, number one, the meeting opened at 6 p.m., not 7 p.m. Number two, what purpose does taking pictures of our personal items serve? Are you going to publish them? And so my husband's Purple Heart truck tag is special, and he did not appreciate it being published without his permission. Number three, I spoke with Chris Barton, the Van Zandt DA. He is possibly going to turn over all the correspondence to the Attorney General's office, which in turn will forward to TEA in Austin if the investigation warrants. Number four, a master could be sent to the Grantsland ISD for an undetermined amount of time, 6 to 12 months. The Grantsland ISD taxpayers would be responsible with the tax money to pay living expenses, rent in home or apartment, utilities, gasoline expense, and salary of the master, which would cost the district $150,000 plus for the extent of the investigation. Number five, the 30-plus member group that at the board meetings and speaking in open public forum is flooding the DA's office with allegations against the board and the board attorney. The same group has spoken at every meeting about the board spending money, but they are going to cause the Grantsland ISD district to spend hundreds of thousands of taxpayer money for a master and take away that money from the students and education. This seems to be a double-edged sword. You complain about money spent, but you're willing to spend over $150,000 for a master. Number six, one member of the group who has been vocal at the board meetings is running for seat to finish the one-year term that was left vacant when Dan Carroll left. Mr. Blake, are you willing to cost the district that money? Number seven, Ron Rell has never called me. I've never spoken to anyone from TEA over the phone. Ms. Weaver, where did you get this information? You certainly did not ask me. You have never asked me to respond to any questions or comments that you have printed in the Grantsland Sun. You have spoken to me one time and told me you had been spelling my name wrong, and it's obvious you didn't get any of your facts correct. Number eight, the statement is correct that Kathy Thomason locked the door. It was an error on her part, and the board didn't know anything about the locked door until we came out and Charles Revere and you started shouting at us. Kathy Thomason unlocked the doors, but it took her about 20 minutes to do so because she was inside the building cleaning up and putting everything back in its proper place. Number nine, the September 15th, 2010 call meeting. Misappropriation of grant money. This was brought to the board's attention by Trish Elliott, and Ms. Elliott is in charge of the grants. Present at that meeting were board members John Hardy and John Hardy Jr. They were the board attorneys, Mark Cady, Joey Jones, and Trish Elliott. It started at 6:30 p.m. and ended at 12:25 a.m., 6 hours. The board spoke with Joey Jones first, Trish Elliott second. Victor Colling was in the hallway going to the middle school library when Charles Revere came through the double doors leading into the commons area. Victor Colling told Mr. Revere this was a closed meeting and he could not come in. Mr. Revere stated he would come in and no one could stop him. The board attorney stopped him at the library door and told him this was a closed meeting, and Mr. Revere stated again he could come in and no one could stop him. I was the only one in the library that knew who Charles Revere was, and he was dressed in camo. And was insistent with the attorneys that no one could stop him. Mark Cady told Mr. Revere to leave. Mr. Revere left, and the board called Mark Cady into the library. The board and attorneys asked Mr. Cady how and why Mr. Revere is at the school. Mr. Cady's reply was, Charles Revere is at my house and called me, and I told him I was at the school at a board meeting. Mr. Cady stated Mr. Revere had been in his office for 2+ hours. But the main outside doors were locked. As Vita Weaver stated in her newspaper article, that Mark Cahee was the one who locked them because everyone else was in the library. Mr. Cahee and Mr. Revere were the only ones in the commons area that goes to the administration office. Ms. Elliott and Mr. Jones was in their office in the back. Mark Cahee was the superintendent and was in charge of locking and unlocking the main doors to the outside. Because of the belligerent nature of events involving Mr. Revere and other incidents in a board meeting when Mr. Revere shoved a handful of papers in the face of board attorney Mr. Hardy and the nature of some topics on the agenda, I ask for a sheriff's deputy to be present at a meeting for the safety of everyone. Recently in Florida, a man had walked into a school board meeting and pulled a gun on the board. I'm asking for this statement to be recorded in its entirety as a permanent record in board meetings. I'm giving a copy of this statement to the record. Excuse me, Grantsland Sun, Vita Weaver, and the Van Zandt News. I'm requesting that the statement be printed in its entirety in the Grants Lane Sun and the Gazette News so that the Grants Lane ISD taxpaying public will be made aware of the inaccurate quotes, statements, and articles that have been published in the newspaper. I do have other copies for any of the public at this meeting if you so desire. And they were up here.